Please note that the information shared in this video is coming directly from Leiyu Technologies 2019 financial report and the recent publication from Nasdaq. What we will cover today will hint on the future of Warframe and a possible death to the Western market, or the entire game as we know it. This is not a certain future for the company, but the recent financial report and trading tells us that the game, the studio, and the parent company are moving on into a new age. So prepare yourself, because Warframe as we know it is taking a nosedive from here. It is no doubt that Warframe has been declining over the years, either it be in viewership or just concurrent player numbers. These are things that your average Warframe player or your average gamer can just pull up and see. But what about the insides of the company, the finances, and everything that determines if a studio stays afloat or not? Warframe has been losing millions over the past 2 years. The publications from the parent company Leiyu Technologies also show that even when the company makes a profit within the past 2-3 years, it is not a percentage that was anticipated. It was not a massive growth, rather a very slow growth. And the numbers have been reducing over the years, and they are in fear of a negative growth, which will result in a major loss of money. The shareholders are also planning on selling the company and all their assets. Leiyu Technologies bought Digital Extremes in 2016, and as a result of this deal, the game began to see some major changes, mostly in the rise of microtransactions and cosmetics and the decline of actual content within the game. The similarities can also be drawn with other Leiyu games and other Perfect World IPs. Leiyu is the same company that owns Dirty Bomb and was also forced to remove its monetization in 2019. As I mentioned earlier, the same ownership resulted in Warframe initiating more microtransactions and several loads of cosmetic releases instead of actual content. In Leiyu's very own financial publication, they acknowledged this and they mentioned the loss due to fewer updates. And as for a full release of the 2019 financial report, it is rumored that the company lost more than they did in 2018. As a direct reflection, the holding company also spent more money on marketing and promoting the game, which also ended up in a loss compared to the previous years. Leiyu Technologies, the parent company for Warframe with 97% shares, is in position to sell their entire company, or at least more than 50% share of the company, which includes all assets and IPs. And that is not even the scariest part about this, because on the top of the bidders for this company is a private equity firm CVC, who are now backing iDream Sky Technology in a $1.3 billion bid to buy their longtime rival Leiyu Technologies. iDream Sky and CVC would hold control of the entire franchise and its future. In addition to this, the buyers are also being backed by the Chinese behemoth Tencent, which, as a lot of us know, needs no explanation. With this deal, the controlling shareholders may only retain a small portion of the company, which will then leave Tencent and Co. as the controlling party in any future decisions. I hate to be the bearer of such news, but the deal will mean the death of the old player base and the rise of a new one, if any. This could also determine if the game will survive the 10-year mark or if it will just die. We've seen a similar situation with another Canadian studio in regards to Dauntless. And as we already know, a lot of these buyer companies are well invested in the mobile market, and that seems to be their goal and plans for Warframe. So, for some people, you could have Warframe on your Android devices or your iOS devices. However, in terms of the core of the game, Warframe is no longer the game you fell in love with in 2013. And that is just a reality, and this could be the end of everything. So, if you are a diehard Warframe fan or a diehard Warframe player out there, keep your eyes open as we begin to look at what is going to happen in the future of the company. Anyways, that's going to be it for this video. Thanks for watching. Let me know your thoughts about this down below in the comment section. As always, it's DA signing out. I'll see you guys in the next one.